lighting, or is this lighting good?
It's a little bit too high.
Bro, I hope the dog doesn't bark the whole time.
Hold on.
So I will quickly go over what thrifting by the pound is, just in case you don't know. Instead of paying for everything individually, you pay for how much it weighs. So at the Goodwill bins, it costs $1.79 per pound for clothing. And obviously clothing don't weigh that much. Like, if I actually thrifted this shirt and it weighs nothing, so I could literally get this shirt for less than a dollar. So I'm gonna get into it. I think I paid, I want to say $12, but I honestly don't remember because this was months ago. I just never got around to filming. I kept everything in this bag. This is the bag that I use when I go to the Goodwill bins. It's like a super large tote bag, so I don't have to carry around a bunch of plastic bags. Just super convenient. So I'm gonna start with the clothing items, and then I'm gonna talk about fabrics that I got, because I got a bunch of fabrics. Exciting. First, on the top of the bag, and also I washed everything, so yeah, do that. If you don't be washing your clothes you thrift, do better, babe. Anyway, I got this oversized blazer, which is something that's super trendy for the fall and winter time. As you can see, there's a chunk cut out of it because my intention when I got this was to make it a crop blazer, so I was gonna cut it in half. My older brother, he was here and he needed a pocket square, and he asked me if I had some black fabric that he can use to make a pocket square, and I had this was like the only thing that I had available and open and like accessible. I cut a chunk off of it, but it's totally fine because I was gonna crop it anyway. And now that I think about it though, I could have made the bottom half a skirt. I probably still could. I would just have to sew this part shut since there's a hole there. And I really like this one because it had this buckle, so I feel like that would be cute if I made the other half a skirt. It's really nothing special, just the oversized blazer. It has some pinstripe on it too, but it's black. It's lightweight, which is good because I'm in South Florida and it's super hot out here. Then I got a bunch of shirts that I'm gonna use to do like thrift flips and sewing and stuff like that. So firstly, I got this, and I feel like this would be a cute two-piece set. Like, I can make it a top and a skirt, but if I wanted it to just be a skirt, that would be cute, like a mini skirt like this. I really like the pattern and the feeling of the fabric, and I always go for stretchy fabrics because I feel like it's more flexible and it lays better on the body when you're doing thrift flips. I also got this shirt to do a thrift flip with. I just haven't really decided specifically what I'm gonna do with them. I just like the stuff that has patterns all over it. Even though this pattern and this shirt is ugly, it could be something cute. I feel like that's my magic trick, or my talent is turning nothing into something. Like this, it's not giving. At all. Mm-mm. But once I do something with it, it'll be that girl. Right now though, mm-mm. Again, another thing that's like, no. It is ugly, and I can admit that it's ugly, but when I transform it or make it into whatever I'm gonna make it into, it's gonna be something cute. Really like the sequins on this one. That's really why I bought it, and it has bedazzle too. So I feel like once I, you know, bibbidi bobbidi boop it, then it's gonna be cute.
Me, what a gown this will be.
Because right now, no. Another item that's super ugly. Kind of looks like the other one. I'm looking at it. It has that same vibe. Honestly, I really wonder who was wearing this. Who was wearing this? I want to know. But like I said, I can't bash it too much because I saw the potential in it. But I just know you guys probably don't. This shirt isn't half bad. I mean, it's still ugly, but it's not as ugly as other ones. But this one I plan to turn into bloomers, because you know how bloomers have the ruffles like this on it? I thought this would be perfect. So I don't have to actually make ruffles. This already has all the ruffles I need. So when I cut it down and like make it into a bigger piece of fabric, then I'll be able to make it into shorts. And that would be so freaking cute. I don't think I've really seen red bloomers. I always usually see like white or pastel light colors, like light pink, and that's really it. So I think that would be super super fire to have some red bloomers. And this has clear pieces of sequins on it. I think I'll probably do a video on some thrift flips. Actually, I got these shorts too during that trip, and this is like one of the only things that I kept the same. Here is another skirt. This length of skirt and this type of skirt is something that seems very trendy. I feel like you would probably see something like this on Brandy Melville or something like that. I think it would be really cute though as a mini skirt. I feel like this is a skirt that will look cute with like one of those little, either the little white roses right here or a white little bow right here. Just for like that simple, cute added detail. What else do we have in here? Kind of a surprise to me too, because I haven't looked in this in like a month or so. This is a guest tank top, a normal army green tank top. They use silver thread for the hemline, so I think that's really pretty. You can kind of see it. And this I'm gonna keep the same. I'm probably gonna crop it honestly and cut a slit in the front, but for the most part that's pretty much all I plan on doing it. I don't plan on doing too much with this, but I kind of don't want to crop it because it has this on the bottom, this guest embroidery. Ignore my nails, I know they look crusty. What's in is like wearing long shirts over your pants, kind of like Elena Gilbert. That's the vibe. This top, literally Elena Gilbert in this, is the can't even formulate words. Personally, maybe with a like a tight mini skirt and a jacket I would do that, but not the way Elena was doing it. While we're on the Elena Gilbert train, these shorts. This reminds me of that era of life. They're really low-waisted, barely anything. This is such a small amount of fabric. I actually haven't tried these on yet, so I don't even know if they're gonna fit my waist. What else? Oh, I didn't even know I had these in here. These are cute. A pair of Wrangler shorts, and these are the type of shorts that are really trendy right now too. I feel like, yeah, people wear booty shorts like this, like the ones that I have on right now, but what's really in is like cutoff shorts, you know, longer shorts, longer than this, honestly. Side note, everything smells so good. The detergent that I use to wash these clothes, I need to buy it again. There probably were jeans and somebody cut them into shorts, but I'm not mad at it at all. Not mad at it at all. And here's the little Wrangler tag. Next, I got this button down polka dot shirt again to flip into something else. But now that I'm looking at this, I really didn't need it. I really didn't need this because I got a bunch of other fabric anyway. But I don't know. I thought the pink with the black polka dots was pretty, and I feel like it could be something cute. I just don't know what yet. That's my problem though. I need to get back to sewing because this is a lot of stuff to have just sitting here. And I'm not doing anything with it. Yeah. Ugh. Does anyone else sit on their feet? That's something that I've done since I could even remember. I'm always sitting on my legs, but then it starts to fall asleep or cramp or hurt. Because right now I'm sitting on the floor, so it kind of was hurting. This is originally from Pretty Little Thing. It's a size 6, which is not my size, but I'm sure this will fit me. And I also planned on turning it into a mini dress because this one's quite long. This one goes past my knees, I feel like. Yeah. And I've always wanted a denim dress like this. So when I saw this, I just saw the potential of what it could be. The way that they did the hips is so drastic. Like, come on, be for real. Be for real. It's like Miss Incredible. Babe, I'm not shaped like this. Is this Victoria's Secret? No. It's Oscar de la Renta. And I feel like I've heard someone on TikTok say that this is a good brand. I would have to search it up. But I thought it was really pretty. And I've been into lingerie pieces like this a lot. Even though this one's not my size, someone will appreciate it. And this is the thing I was talking about that would look pretty on that striped skirt. One of these little roses. Obviously, like a white rose would look better on the skirt. It has cute little floral detailing. It's green. You know, one thing I never understood about hauls is the purpose of explaining and like telling the color and everything when you can literally see it. Interesting. I'm gonna continue because I guess that's the culture, whatever. As you can see, it has like pink lining underneath it too. It's really pretty. And even the back has like a V-neck. Well, it's not a neck if it's the back, but a V-back. And the straps are adjustable, which is always fun and fresh and thoughtful. Now I'm gonna quickly go through the fabrics, starting with this pink stripe fabric. It has pink and green and white stripes on it. This one is giving American flag. It has red stars and blue plaid. This one is a floral one. I got a lot of floral fabrics because they had a lot of floral plaid. I got a lot of floral fabrics. Dang. Try to say floral fabric 10 times fast. I don't have a stuttering problem. It's just that's a really difficult phrase to get out without my tongue twisting. Anyway, I got a lot of fabrics with floral on it because they had a lot. And also, I feel like that's all I've been seeing recently, especially in the summer, is that whole like Lana Del Rey vibe. I also got this, and it's like flowers but hearts. I don't really know. It's cute though. This one is really nice because it has gold in it. Kind of reminds me of Christmas though. I don't know when I'm gonna use these fabrics. I'm being so honest. Then I got this pink paisley floral one. I think that one's really pretty. And then I got this blue floral. I also got red polka dots, classic, and this pink floral. Guys, I just couldn't pass it up. It was so cheap. When the woman weighed it, I was like, I might as well. I think it's like 79 cents for houseware or like linen is what they call it. I was like, damn, might as well, you know, like I would pay $12 for all this stuff. So it's like, might as well. This one favors denim, but it's not denim, it's cotton. This one's another one that reminds me of Christmas, but it's strawberries. Look how cute. Strawberries on a vine. So cute. This one's super cute too. It's blue hearts, flowers. Can't tell me it's not cute. And then this one was, I like the texture. Like you can feel the polka dots, but it's a mint green and polka dot fabric. I don't even wear stuff like this, so I'm probably gonna make stuff to sell because a lot of these fabrics I would not wear personally. I thought they were still cute. You know, they're not my style, but I still can appreciate it. I got this one. And I liked this one because it was stretchy. I love working with stretchy fabric. A lot of these are linen, so I don't even know what I'm gonna make with them because I don't really work with fabric like without stretch. But it'll be a cute challenge. This one looks like something that I already got, but they're all different. Same word, different fonts. Nah, this one? Tell me if you've seen this, you wouldn't get it. It's so cute. I don't even know what I'm gonna make with it. But it's like bears with hearts. Aw, look, this one's carrying a heart on a wagon. You can't tell me that's not cute. Cannot tell me. Even if I just have these sitting here, it's so cute. And this one's like the most simple one that I got and probably one that I could do a lot with and maybe even wear it, but it's pink. If you look closely, there's roses on it. You can kind of see. Super cute. The roses are like a lighter pink, so it's very subtle, but still super cute. I think that's it, guys. Yeah. That's all. That's the end of this video. Like I said, if you guys didn't watch the video of me thrifting for this stuff, you should definitely go check it out. It's my last video. I'm trying to get back more consistent on YouTube. Again, I still haven't fully settled. I don't even know when I'm ever gonna be settled. I'm gonna continue trying to make videos for you guys. I don't know how many thrifting videos I'm gonna make because I don't think it would be wise for me to buy more clothes when I still haven't even sorted through the clothes that I have, or the clothes that I have aren't really like, they're not in a designated spot. So I might go thrifting just to like vlog, but I don't think I'm gonna buy stuff because it just wouldn't make sense for me to buy stuff right now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will be posting more videos. I have a lot of footage that I could possibly edit, maybe turn into a vlog. If you missed me and you have other social media platforms, you should definitely follow me on Instagram and TikTok because I'm super active on those accounts. I think that's really all I have to say. So bye guys.